But I'm happy to support a smaller brand, and I'm also happy to have more players in the sports watch industry. Hey everyone, and welcome back on the channel. My name is Alex, and I'm very happy to see you today again for a new video, a different one compared to what we're doing here on the channel most of the time. Today we're talking about my watch, the Coros Space 2. I'm gonna say it up front, this is not a specs review or anything very technical. For that, there are other videos on YouTube. I recommend Ray at DC Rainmaker, or for French people, you can check naken.ch, very, very nice channel as well. In this video, I will give you 5 reasons why I would purchase this watch again. And I will also mention 5 features or 5 things that I would like to see improved on the next iteration of this watch, the Coros Space 2. Let's begin with the 5 reasons why I would purchase this watch again. First of all, the price, $199, €199. It's really affordable for, you know, those GPS fitness type of watches. Compared to the previous watches that I owned, I had the Fenix 5S, the 645 and the 945. These watches were all in the $400, $500, $600 ballpark. Here we're talking $200, €199, €199. Great pricing, and for that money, I mean, you know, it's a no-brainer, right? Second reason, and very important for my training, because I'm training based on power and my power source is my Stride pod, the integration with Stride is flawless. So you have, you know, the sensor is picked up by the watch very easily, and that's fantastic. But also, if I forget my Stride sensor, which sometimes, you know, may happen, the native power data on the watch is actually very reliable and very close to the Stride power. Except of course for the air resistance, which you get on the Stride Wind version, and this does not take into account air resistance. But for the core power that you generate, this is very close to the Stride power, and it's amazing, you know, to just be able to put another sensor on the shoes, like the Run Scribe pods, and go out run without worrying that the power data and then the training metrics may be different. Also, in the Stride integration, I have to mention that on the app, you have all the graphs that you would get normally on the Stride app. So for instance, you know, air power, form, vertical oscillation, and all that stuff, you have it directly on the Coros app. You know, don't need to check the 2 apps. You have everything on the Coros app, and that integration is also very nicely done and very useful. Another reason why I really like this watch is the weight, 29 grams with the nylon strap, and the form factor. It's 42 millimeters of diameter, which is fine for a little wrist like mine, or at least below average, I'd say. If you want to be more aero on the bike and lose less power, I do not recommend wearing a watch. But should you be wearing one, this one is a good one because of the limited thickness. You do not generate too much aerodynamic drag, which is obviously good. Another great thing about this watch that I really like, and that was and that is really different compared to the other watches that I owned previously, that's the battery life. Amazing battery life. You can go up to 14 days. I tend to get around 7 to 10 days, depending on the number of activities run and, you know, GPS tracked activities mostly. But, you know, even 7 to 10 days is actually quite nice, and more than what I was experiencing before. Way more than you know, the 1 to 2 days that you may get on an Apple Watch, for instance. So this is a big difference. And you also get the very nice battery life graph showing, you know, the changes in the battery life and how much battery power you're draining based on the activities that you're doing, and also a prediction of how much autonomy you have left. This is also a nice feature, nothing outstanding, but a nice feature for sure. Last but not least, and this may be interesting for you watching this video and owning watches from different brands, Coros is a little brand, and I actually like supporting smaller companies. I previously had Garmin watches, and at the end I was less happy, let's put it that way, with the customer support they had. It wasn't outstanding, and I had quite some issues with their watches, which did not happen with this one. Okay, it's more simple, and of course, you know, everything that's more simple maybe is less problem prone, let's put it that way. But I'm happy to support a smaller brand, and I'm also happy to have more players in the sports watch industry. This is good for innovation, for competition, and at the end, for the consumer, for us. So, you know, this is also a reason why I would most likely go for another Coros watch if I had to buy one today. Now let's get to the five things that I would like to see improved on this watch, and that may be drawbacks for you if you're looking to buy one. First of all, the lack of music. I'm not listening to music when I'm running, or at least, let's say 80-90% of the time, I'm not listening to music. When I'm listening to something, it's more a podcast, or sometimes music when I'm on the treadmill, for instance. But so the lack of music isn't a major drawback for me. Now, if the watch had it, I would be happy to put a few podcasts and listen from time to time to them, but that's something that could be improved in the future. Also, for my personal use and sports, there is no duathlon profiles. There is a triathlon profile, which allows you to essentially start with the swim and then just, you know, click, you go to transition, click, you go to the bike, click, you go to the second transition, and then again click and you go to the run. It does not exist for duathlon, and you cannot create a custom profile for this. It's not a major drawback because I'm not using my watch for the bike leg of a duathlon. I have a bike computer, and I do not care about recording the times of my transitions because this is not what transitions are meant to be. I race to win, or at least to do the best possible results I can. And so I'm not clicking on my watch during transitions because this is a loss of time. I can check the times that I had in transition on the results sheets at the end of the race. But still, if it had a duathlon profile, it would be easier for me not to start a new run activity after the bike leg, but that's not a major drawback, something Coros maybe can improve on the next iteration of this watch. Now, something that many of us experience with the native optical heart rate sensor at the back of the watch, it's the inaccuracy when sitting on the wrist. And this is the case as well for this watch, so no big surprise here. It's not as accurate as those chest straps or a bicep strap, but there is a hack to this, and this is thanks to the nylon strap. You can actually just put your watch on your forearm like this. You have the reading is easy to do, and then the sensor works much better than when sitting on the wrist. So if you don't want to have, you know, a chest strap or a bicep strap, you can just use the watch like this and turn the drawback into actually a positive, because it's, you know, easy to use and you get nice readings this way. That's with the nylon strap. Of course, you cannot do it with the silicone one, so just so you know. Another drawback, or at least something that again could be improved, and this is related to a positive point that I mentioned, the fact that the watch is lightweight. It's made of plastic, and you know, plastic may feel a bit cheap. It's well built, no issues in terms of build quality, but it feels a little cheap. So if you are used to those, I don't know, titanium or even, you know, steel watches, it may not be for you, simply because you won't be happy with the look and the feel of the plastic case. I have no complaints, and I prefer to have a lightweight watch that I do not feel on my wrist for those very long events. And yeah, I mean, so not a drawback, but you know, if Coros could have two versions, one plastic with the, you know, gorilla glass, and the other one titanium with the sapphire glass, why not? But again, here, not a drawback, just something that could be made in the future. Last drawback about the charger, it's a dedicated Coros charger. It's not a USB-C or micro USB type of charger, so if you forget yours, then even with the great battery life, at some point you won't have battery in your watch anymore, and the charger and the port does not feel very secure, so when you plug it in, it's a bit, you know, loosey-goosey, and it's not amazing in terms of feel when you plug it in. Apparently there's a new one that just released that you can even put on your keys, and that works better for some reason, but yeah, this is a minor drawback, and this is me being a bit, you know, nitpicky, but hey, that's the purpose of the video. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this sort of review, or at least my perspective on the Coros Pace 2 watch. I hope this was useful for you. If you have questions about the watch, I'm more than happy to answer to them in the comment section below. Thank you very much to all of you who answered to my first community post about running socks. I am going to order them today and prepare for a mega review with tons of different running socks in the near future. If you enjoyed this video, do not hesitate, hit that subscribe button, give it a thumbs up. It really helps you know, the channel and my motivation quite a bit. I see you guys in the next video. In the meantime, enjoy your run today, your ride, go beyond your limits, and most importantly, take care. Bye bye, guys.